Hi guys, it's NXBerry, and this is going to be a YouTube video about cannon mechanics in Minecraft. If you know me, I love cannon mechanics. Before we start, there are three things you have to work for when you're making a cannon. I'm going to use these three items as an example. So, first thing that you need to work on in making a cannon is safety and reliability. If it's going to explode on itself, you want to make sure that the dispensers are lined up so that when it fires, it has a random chance of making it a little bit to the left. The entity, it may bounce around and may land on any non-water, because when it lands in water, it won't explode. See how it bounced right there? It wasn't fully on the water block and making it explode. So that's something that you have to look out for when you're making your cannon. Another thing that you have to work on is how far you want the cannon to be fired. If you want the cannon to be fired really far, you're going to have to put more cannons. A safe way to put more cannons on this design that I have is to put it under, so it won't have a chance of going a little bit forward, a little bit back. It'll just go up and down and get safely caught by the water. When a prime TNT is in the water, it won't like explode and do environmental damage, ruining your cannon. The final thing that you have to work for is how many TNTs that you want to shoot from your cannon. I call this the arms of the cannon, and it's one of the most important parts of the cannon, because that's what you use it for in a PvP situation. There's also a fourth one, but it really depends on what you're needing the cannon for. It's how fast you can build it. Oops. Efficiency of space is another important one that sort of goes along with safety. Right here is a very simple design. It's three cannons of TNT for the propellant and the dispenser. You don't want to make sure that you don't want to waste any blocks, because if the water that you're using is way too far off on the TNT, it won't work towards making the velocity of the arm farther. So when you press this button, the TNT will activate, and that thing will. You also want to make sure that the timing on the redstone repeaters is good enough so it won't explode in your face. I don't really have a great example of how to tune these. I just want to say process of elimination, because if you're going to do a one like this, I'd recommend four repeaters about to the last tick it can have. If you were to be any longer, the enemy might be able to see where the cannon is coming from, and then they will be able to counterfire or put water next to it so it won't explode. So the efficiency and the damage of the cannon is also really important. Now, if I want to increase not the rate of fire, but the amount that it fires, what you should do is that because I already have the timing down, I can just put a second cannon here. Now, this breaks one of the rules that the safety of the cannon, but because wherever it will land, it will still be near the explosion, that can propel it, it won't like explode in your face. Let's arm this. How much TNT is? Okay, so I just fired it twice. Now it's fired this again. See, it fires two separate TNT. I'm gonna press this. So you can still see how you notice that the higher it goes, I call it the swing of the TNT, will be less precise, which doesn't really matter if you already have the timing down on the cannon, but you want to make sure that you make a simpler one and then find ways how to upgrade it. Another one is conservation of space. So if we want this to fire more, instead of putting it above, like this, it will have the precise of landing in the water will be less. So, you want to put it under the water, so when it comes up, there will be twice the amount of TNT in the propellant without taking up any space. Oops. There we go. So let's put this there, and then if we put three repeaters there, if we don't put three repeaters and we just use the redstone, it won't activate because it won't be directly hitting the block. It will just be sort of in that general direction, as far as I know. So, let's fill these with TNT. I am suddenly French. A bad French stereotype. So, there. Now, press the button. Now that we have increased how much propellant is in the TNT, it shall go farther. As you can see, the original, you can see when there are fresh blocks, that means that that was the part that was recently destroyed. You can also tell by the grass. And the grass thing, I think, only works if you really, like, take a couple minutes to, like, wait for the grass to grow over so you can tell if the fire was new or not. So you can tell where it has been landed. So those are some things that you should take into account when you're making a cannon. If I were to want to make this more efficient and take up less space, what I would do is that I would make a dispenser there, and then fill that with TNT, so it will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7 different prime, let's call it propellant TNT, activating two different ones. Another safety issue is that you don't want to put anything above, like exactly below where the ammo is going to fire. So just in case if it goes up vertically, then it does horizontally, then it will blow up the cannon. So try out your own design for a cannon. I don't really know how the rating of how safe it is or how that would work, but I just think I just wanted to make a very technical video because I'm a very technical person. I might not seem like it, but I like to think about stuff. So, hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Like, share, subscribe, whatever. See you guys in the next episode. Boop!